Good afternoon, His Excellency, President of MEDC, ladies and gentlemen. I am happy to be here speaking on financing the economy. This is the fourth time I think I am talking about blue economy now. First one, my first speech was in the Magnetic Maharashtra conference. That time it was general aspects of blue economy. Today it is about financing the blue economy. I have heard the speeches by various experts. I'm happy to know that India was a leading shipbuilder in the world. So when Rajendra Chola Idol was opened in Mazagon Dock, I was there for the function. And that time only I came to know that India was a leading power in naval. And today, when I attended this conference, I came to know that India was a leading power. Of course, all of you are aware that before 1700, they said that India was a leading economy in the world because of our naval power. So this is the time we can get back to the old glory of using the blue economy. So if you look at the blue economy, what are the emerging trends? Today I am just summarizing fast. So 95% of trading by volume and 70% by value is done through maritime transport today. And 12 coastal economic regions as part of plans, I heard that it is much more today. 6 new major ports would be developed. Now government has allowed 100% FDI. There is a 10-year tax holiday to enterprises. And if you see in the last 4 years, if you see the performance of this government, especially in the port sector, the profitability of all the ports have gone up more than 2 times in the last 4 years. And if you look at the turnaround time at the airports, actually, the turnaround time has reduced from 94 hours to 64 hours. And of course, the project by government by Unnati has been started by Government of India to identify opportunity areas for improvement in the operations of major ports. So there are 116 initiatives identified, out of which 91 initiatives have been implemented as of November 2018. Under the Sagarmala program, the government has 189 projects for modernization of ports, involving around 22 billion by the year 2035. So, and of course, the capacity, doubling of capacity was discussed in the earlier sessions. The government has a plan to more than double the capacity. And why develop the blue economy? As we have seen in the case of Norway, they said 70% of their exports is through blue economy. You look at countries like Singapore, Hong Kong. So mostly these economies thrive on sea-based trade. Trade is their main income. So there is a great potential for blue economy to contribute to 20% of GDP. Suppose if you say that an Indian economy will reach $5 trillion, by then $1 trillion can come from the blue economy. So if you see logistics costs in the world, India, we are one of the highest logistics costs in the world, which is about 15%. So if we develop the blue economy in a big way with the integrated strategy, then it can be brought down to 10%, which will be a clear 5% savings to the Indian economy, the transportation costs. Already there are major initiatives on the way. Then if you look at, I believe there was a discussion yesterday on cost of shipping. As you look at all the modes of transportation, the cheapest is through pipeline. Whatever you can send it through pipeline, there will be the cheapest mode of transportation. After that, the cheapest mode of transportation is through water. So if you compare with railways or roadways, if you develop coastal shipping in a big way, the cost of transportation will be 1/7 of railways. You know, railways is again the cheapest mode of transport today within India, and 1/10 of the road transportation. So what are the commodities which can be shifted through coastal shipping? People talked about bulk commodities in the morning. So the commodities like coal, cement, food grains, steel and fertilizers through water transportation. Especially people in the morning, they talked about Chhattisgarh and other adjoining regions. Iron